Hey, Ninjapreneur, how's it going? My name is Misty Dorman. I'm a Heartbeat Community Platform expert. And in this video, I'm going to show you how to use Heartbeat's new workflows feature with their other new automated groups feature to dramatically boost engagement in your community, especially for new members. So I just want to show you a workflow that I've created in my own community. I'm going to show you step by step how to do it in yours. You're going to be blown away by what these new features can do. So first thing that you want to do is create your bonus content. So the strategy here, the overall idea, is that you're going to offer bonus content to people for performing certain actions. And those actions will be something like creating their first post and getting their first so many comments done on other people's posts, okay? And so the first thing you need to do is create what your bonus content is. I recommend creating a mini course, or my best idea right now is to create a challenge in the course area of your community. I used a 5-day challenge for this. You could test out doing something longer, something shorter, but here's why I recommend a challenge. Number one, because if you drip out lessons one day at a time, they're going to get a notification every single day that the new content is available. And that's going to get them into a daily habit right after they've joined your community of returning to your community every day for content. And that can't be a bad thing, right? Two, you can use an automation tool like Zapier or Pabbly to add them to an access tag or list in your email program. And then you can have an email sequence that emails them every day during your challenge as well. So they're going to get the notifications inside of the community. They're also going to receive the emails. Now, I have not tested it. You could probably set up emails within the workflow itself. I just tend to have some of that stuff set up in my own email automation tool because I might be driving other people to the challenge in a different way, for example. And so however you want to do that is fine. If you are going to connect it to your email tool, I recommend doing that right up here after you've created the bonus content. Okay. And then this is just an example of what my challenge looks like. It's right in my courses area, which I've renamed Learn. I know this might be a little bit small on your screen. Incidentally, I am putting this into my Heartbeat admin resource guide, which is a free guide for you. And there's a whole bunch of other things in there as well. So I'm just going to add this in there for anybody who has that guide. You can sign up below in the description. Okay, so that's what mine looks like. Next thing you're going to do is create an announcement post detailing how to unlock your bonus. Okay. And so you're going to make an announcement post, tag all of your members on it, and it's going to say something like this. And I'm not going to read through it all, but just tell them this is how you're going to unlock your special bonus content. What is the content? How do you get it? In my example, they have to make one post and make 4 comments. The reason for that is because I'm using a format from Brie Lever, community expert, who she had created some emails when she was the community manager at Heartbeat that encourage members to do what she calls a 411. And so part of that, the 4 and the first or second one, I can't remember the order, but it was make your first 4 comments and create your first post. I think the other one is send a DM. Okay. And so this is going to just tie into the email I'm already sending to my new community members, which I'm telling them go comment on 4 posts and make your first post, right? So that's what I'm doing there. And then after you create an announcement post like this, you want to use the 3 dots in the upper right-hand corner of the thread or the post and save it to your docs area. This is going to make it so that you can link to it. You can tag that doc. So anytime you have a new member, for example, when they onboard into your community and their first post goes into that intros thread, then you or your VA, whoever, could comment on there and say, hey, by the way, we have a special bonus you can unlock, and they can tag right over to that doc. How cool is that? And it also makes it so that the comments that are added to the post or the doc are actually added in both places. It's all tied together. So the comments will show up in both places. So if you get quite a bit of engagement going already, you can see in this example, I could only fit so much on my screenshot, but immediately after I posted this, people started commenting like, hey, I'm super excited. Let's go. I love bonuses. You know, like people were actually posting right away and commenting right away because they wanted to get their first four comments, right? These couple of people already had their first four comments, but you get where I'm going with this, right? Okay. The next step in this process is to add text to your welcome posts and your getting started doc. So if you have like a start here channel or a pinned welcome post, go ahead and add a blurb to it about the special bonus. That way new members that are coming in maybe don't see this post that you just made because it's 6 months from now. They are going to see that in the getting started doc and in the welcome post. So these are just examples. And again, you can grab the admin resource guide and, you know, zoom in on these and see everything really well. I just added this little quick start blurb to my my start here thread. And right here, you can see under step three in my getting started doc, I put in this little pink box with a star, you know, that when they create their first thread, a comment on four posts, they unlock this special bonus content. So that's how I've done it in mine. Okay, the next step is to create a hidden automated group with a workflow. Okay. Mine, I actually have a parent group called Hidden Groups. Nobody has access to, like, nobody's a member of that hidden group, but I just put all of my hidden groups underneath this as subgroups just to keep it organized for myself. I can kind of minimize this when I don't want to see all that if I'm looking at my groups list. And so I just created a subgroup called Made First Two Posts Plus Four Comments. Nobody's ever going to see that but me and potentially some other admins or moderators on my team. So, you know, just and same for you. So just name it whatever you want to name it. It's going to be hidden. Nobody's going to see the name. Okay. And then here are a few screenshots of the settings in my group. So you can just kind of mimic what I've done here, make it work for you. So I've got the title, the description. I made all these black so that they're not colored like my other groups. I don't want to get them confused. I want to be able to easily spot the hidden and automated groups. And then I selected automate here. Okay. I've got comments greater than three. That means four or more comments. That's a requirement in the filters area here. They had to make at least four comments and posts greater than one. Now, the reason I did not set that to greater than zero or however it would be worded is because when they onboard, they already have an intro post created for them automatically. I want them to manually go out and type a post. I don't want their intro post to count. So I need them to make actually their second post, which would be their first post that they make themselves. Okay. And I also put in here that admins and moderators are not included in this. We don't need special access to this or to show up in the list of members of this group. So I have it excluding those people. Okay, on the next page in the settings, I've selected hidden up at the top and it's not isolated. And I know this is very small probably, but what you'll see here is that there's this workflow section. This is the new thing that Heartbeat just added. You will also see workflows in the sidebar in your admin area. So you can just go straight into workflows and add your workflows. Whatever you've added to workflows is going to show up where it belongs. So you can find easy access to it. So in my example, I already had this group going and I had a Pabbly automation that was doing this work for me. And so I just took that out of Pabbly and added it to the workflows section. And I noticed when I went in to edit this group, it showed up right here. So how convenient is that? You can just create it right from the jump on the group creation screen. It's going to say something like add workflow. And the things, the actions that I've added here to the workflow is to send them a DM after showing them a pop-up. So I first want it, as soon as they're added to this group, I wanted to show a pop-up that's like, yay, you just unlocked your bonus content, right? And then I'm also sending them a DM. That might be an optional step for you, and I'll explain that in just a minute. When we click into edit my content right here so that you can see what I've added, just as an example, this is what my pop-up looks like. So I wonder if I can just make this a little bigger, actually. There we go. Oh, that's nice. Okay. So this is what it looks like in my pop-up. I'm saying you unlocked a special bonus and here's how you earned it to thank you for diving in and getting engaged. I'm giving you free access to, mine is called the 5 Must Have Mindsets for Success Challenge. This is a 5-day challenge. I'm letting them know exactly what this is, because if they don't want this, I don't necessarily want them to click in and get access to it. And I'll probably explain that again in a minute as well. But basically, I want them to have to click into it. Okay, now, the easiest thing to do is to put in the link area right here, to put just a link straight into the content, and you can just select it from the dropdown. So if you've created your like a course already, for example, mine's a challenge inside of a course. So I could have just directly linked them right over to it where it's like, here, go access your content. Because by the time they've got to this step, they've received the pop-up, they've already been added to this group, right? So then all we will have to do later is just give access to the group on the actual content itself. So on the course, we'll say, you know, make sure this group has access. However, in my case, and possibly in your case, I actually have other people who have access to this challenge and may access it from other means. And so I'm actually giving them an invitation link right here. So I actually had pasted, it's not showing up in the screenshot, which is fine, but I pasted an invitation link right here, which invites them to join the challenge group. Okay. And I want them to physically click that button and join that challenge group. Part of the reason for that is because I'm going to be sending them a notification every day as their daily lesson gets unlocked, and I'm going to be sending them an email every day. I don't want to overwhelm someone if they didn't actually want to be part of this challenge. I don't want to annoy them into actually like leaving my community or something like that, right? Or not wanting content from me. I want them to actually opt in. So if that's the case for you, then you can actually just put an invitation link to the main content access group. I hope that makes sense. And I put a little fun GIF on here of Kronk saying mission accomplished. And right here, this is a really cool feature. You can choose a celebration. So it's going to pop up something like fireworks or confetti or this cool light up on their screen as like a little like woohoo, right? And don't we all love to feel celebrated? So you can actually preview that celebration and choose the one that you want. You could add a cover image or your own video. I just chose to add a GIF because that was quick and easy for me in that moment. Okay, how do I get back out of here? Okay, so I've already explained this part. If you grab the admin resource guide, you'll have this, or just screenshot it if you need to. I'm just explaining how you might determine what link that you're going to put on this button that shows up in the pop-up window. Okay, and so I explained that I'm putting mine as an invitation link. And because I'm doing that, and because they might click it and then not actually join, they might be like, oh, I'm going to join that later. They will kind of like lose that pop-up and they'll lose the invitation link. So I'm also sending them a DM 5 minutes. You can see right here, it says send after 5 minutes from initial trigger. So 5 minutes later, I'm saying, hey, in case you missed the pop-up notification, I want to make sure you still have the details. And I have this little blurb right here that says, click here to access your bonus. Once you've done that, you'll find your 5-day challenge in the learn area of this community. I'm just letting them know where to go and find it. And so, like I said, if you're actually just giving them immediate access to the content instead of like making them opt in separately, then you might not need this DM, or you might want to use this DM as an opportunity to, you know, have it send out like a few days later and just follow up with them, see if they're enjoying your bonus. I might do that as well. I don't know. The sky's the limit here, right? You can add all kinds of cool actions to this workflow. Just get in there and dig around and see what works great for you. Okay. And then the next step is to make sure the group has access to the content. Now you want to do this as soon as possible after you've finished creating your workflow and, you know, saved your group, because immediately anyone who already has qualified to access your bonus content has just gotten a pop-up telling them to go access their bonus content, that they've unlocked it. And so you need to make sure that they actually have access. So right away, go and click the three dots next to your content. I'm going to call it a course for right now because that's probably where most of you will put your bonus content. It could be a doc. It could be something else. But go ahead and click the three dots next to it. Click edit in my screenshot. This is for a course. The doc will look a little bit different, but you can, you know, select who has access. And so in my case, this challenge already has its own student group, and I'm giving them an invitation link to join this group. So this group already has access. We're good to go. If that's not the case for you and you need the sheer act of becoming a member of your bonus group, created two posts and four comments, you know, whatever you called your group, then you need to add that here. Okay. You need to give that new group that you just created with the workflow, give that access to this area. Okay. I think that's it. It's really, I know this looks like a lot of steps, but it's very easy. If you just follow along, watch back through this video again, if you need to grab the admin resource guide, I'm going to link that below. You know, thanks for watching. Please make sure to subscribe if you want more content like this, and just check the video description for any helpful links I have related to Heartbeat and the admin resource guide. And I will see you next time. Bye, Ninjapreneur.